Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. Welcome to Module 7 of this RoboDK professional training. In this module, we will explore some advanced robot simulation tool. This is the kind of tool you have within the simulation environment that helps you improve the quality of your real-life robot integration. You can think about collision checking, cycle time analysis, reach study, singularity avoidance, and more. Let's get started. This first video will be relatively short. My goal here is just to give you an idea of the different topics we'll be covering. So first of all, we will talk about collision checking. So this is very important if you want to make sure that your robot does not collide with your general environment while you're running your program. We will then talk about Euler angles. Euler angles are a way to represent the position of either a target or a tool or reference frame within a 3D space. But depending on the brand you're using, the way they represent that orientation isn't the same. So it's important for you to properly understand how this is handled within RoboDK. We will then talk about singularities. What are singularities? How RoboDK detects those and how you can avoid them. We will then talk about rounding or blending or continuous motion or zone data, depending on the vocabulary of the specific robot brand you're using. This will be a nice segue to our next subject, which will be speed and acceleration. In certain applications, making sure that you have a very specific or very constant speed with respect to the part you're trying to work on is super important. So we'll have to see how RoboDK handles that. This will bring us to the next subject, which will be cycle time analysis or cycle time estimation, in fact. So how RoboDK can give you a very good idea of how much time a given task will take. We will then jump to reach study. So reach study is how to make sure that all the targets or all the paths you need to follow with the robot are within the reach or within the range of a given robot, the robot you're using. So that's cool. We will then go to input and output. So inputs and outputs are a way to interact with your environment, so they are important. So how you can trigger an output from RoboDK, how you can wait for an input from RoboDK, and how this will translate to the program you are generating at the end of the day. This will be, again, a nice segue to our next subject, which will be robot synchronization. So how to synchronize either a robot with the mechanism or either two robots together when they are working on a task, so making sure that they are waiting for one another at given time or at a given point in your program. And then we will finish with a very other important topic, which is replace robot. So this is very interesting for people that are kind of doing some case study or are trying to figure out which robot they should use in a given project. So you can program the whole program with one robot, and then with just a few clicks, you can replace that robot with another from the local library. So you don't have to reprogram the whole thing, and then you'll be able to do a new reach study with the new robot, a new cycle time analysis with the new robot, a new collision checking with the new robot without having to recreate everything from scratch. So that's super useful. So like I said, in the next video, we'll talk about collision checking. I really hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys.